Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. I'm Dr. Abia Siddharth from Anatomy Department, Sahara Medical College. Today I'm going to discuss with you the anatomy of pleura and lungs. So it's a very important topic of thorax, and I'm going to divide it into three sections. Today I'm going to discuss the anatomy of pleura and the external features of lung. And in the next two lectures, I'm going to discuss the internal features, the tracheobronchial tree, bronchopulmonary segments, and the clinical features related to these topics. So today we're going to discuss the anatomy of pleural sac, different parts of the pleura, parietal pleura, visceral pleura, the different subdivisions of the parietal pleura, and the pockets of pleural cavity entrapped by these subdivisions and their reflections. We'll also discuss nerve supply and blood supply of pleura, and then in the lungs we're going to discuss the external features of the lungs and the differences which are observed on gross examination for the right and left lung. The thoracic cavity, as we can observe here in the CT scan as a cross section, is a kidney shaped cavity. The central part of the cavity is occupied by heart and the pericardial sac, while the lateral parts are covered by the lungs and pleural cavities. Anteriorly, it is limited by the sternum. Posteriorly, the vertebral column is indenting this cavity. And laterally, there are ribs and intercostal spaces. So we have two pulmonary cavities, right and left. And the central part with we can observe the heart lying and other viscera and nerves, lymph nodes, blood vessels, thoracic parts of the great vessels. They are lying in this median septum, which is called mediastinum. The superior limit of this cavity is the thoracic inlet. The inferior limit is thoracic outlet, which is lined by diaphragm. Pleural membrane or pleura is a serous membrane making a closed sac, which is called pleural sac. Now, it is a serous membrane. That means that it is lying on the inner side of the sac by simple squamous cells, which are mesothelial cells, and they are going to secrete a serous fluid, which is called pleural fluid. This serous fluid is present in the space which is called pleural cavity. Now we can imagine this space as a balloon here, which is indented by the lungs from the medial side. When the lungs indent the pleural sac, there is a layer of pleura which is going to be in direct contact with the lungs. Here you can observe, which is known as the visceral pleura. The visceral pleura is going to line all the surfaces of lungs, all the fissures, even may dip into the fissures. And visceral pleura is basically adherent to lungs, and when we do dissection and observe the lung in cadaveric specimen, we cannot differentiate or separate visceral pleura from the lungs. At the hilum or root of lung, which is here on the medial surface, where structures are passing in the lung or exiting the lung, we can observe that the visceral pleura is reflected as parietal pleura. Parietal pleura is lining all the structures lying outside and on the periphery of the pleural cavities. So on the medial side, the parietal pleura is going to line the mediastinum. It is going to make the lateral margin of the mediastinum. So here it is called the mediastinal pleura. And then reflected on the apex of the lung, this is called cervical pleura or cupula. From here it is continuous on the inner lining of the thoracic wall, and here it is called the costal part. And then on the inferior aspect, you can observe here that it is reflected and forms the superior lining of the diaphragm, and here it is called diaphragmatic pleura. So parietal pleura and these peripheral structures are separated by connective tissue layers. So as you can observe here that the cervical pleura is covered by a thick connective tissue layer, which is called suprapleural membrane. So this suprapleural membrane is going to protect the apex of the lung at cervical pleura. Then here the mediastinal part is separated by a connective tissue, thin, loose connective tissue layer from the fibrous pericardium. And here you can observe that diaphragmatic surface is separated from the actual part of diaphragm by a loose connective tissue layer, which is called phrenicopleural fascia. And then the costal surface is separated from the thoracic wall by loose connective tissue fascia, which is called endothoracic fascia. So basically this is endothoracic fascia, which is continued on the diaphragmatic surface as phrenicopleural fascia and also partially on the mediastinal surface. Just the part above the thoracic inlet is thickened to form the suprapleural membrane. And this is here just to protect the apex of the lung, which is protruding into the root of the neck. Now these facial layers are very important, especially when thoracic surgery is being performed and we are to enter the thoracic cavity but not to open the pleural cavity. The thoracic surgeons, they, after penetrating all the layers of thoracic wall, when they reach endothoracic fascia, they do the blunt dissection and separate the parietal pleura away and then enter the plane of the endothoracic fascia to enter the thoracic cavity and not penetrate the pleural cavity.